Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak on the Appropriation Bill 2019, which means the supply or spending bill authorizing the expenditure of certain further government funds from consolidated fund for the financial year. Before going into the bill, sir, there are so many central government schemes which are being given to the states and to the rural and to the poor out of the taxpayers' money. I would like to know, and I would like to say that when the finance minister also was speaking, it was good that they felt proud that certain schemes they have eradicated corruption by distributing money directly into the accounts of Manegra workers. But to say, even to get that work, they have to give, there is corruption at the ground level. I hope the finance minister will take note of that and see to it that the schemes which the central government gives from the taxpayers' money goes and reaches the downtrodden, the poorest of the poor, the women, and benefits them. And another thing I would like to say, certain government schemes should be useful. I have seen so much of schemes, especially let me tell one example of the open defecation free scheme, where there are thousands and thousands of toilets, lakhs of toilets constructed throughout the country, thousands of toilets constructed in my constituency, where I can challenge that not even five, okay, to be given a margin, let me say even 10% is not in use. They spend around 12,000 rupees for the toilet scheme, which the central government gives a share of rupees 3,500. And just imagine the amount of money because they say that with that amount it is impossible to construct a toilet. They have just taken the money, it's a room, and it is not in use. And I can, even if somebody, if the minister can send representatives, I can take them to my constituency and I would challenge them to prove that even if more than 10% of the toilets are in use, which have been. So what is happening to the money that is being spent, lakhs of crores of money which is being spent by the government, is just now that it goes down the drain. In this scheme, it has gone down the sewage. So when the central government has got a scheme, they should know within 1 year whether it is feasible, or they should revisit the plan and try to make things work. So that is one suggestion which I think. And I would also like to take this opportunity, Chair, through you, like when we want to give a transparent, when we want to be corrupt-free, when we want to serve the people and this thing, I think let me take this opportunity to ask the finance minister to raise the salary of the MPs, which I think both the benches from the opposition and this thing too would agree with me. And also the MP lads, it is too meager an amount, because I have six constituencies and an MLA gets 3 crores per constituency. I think it is high time that we increase.
In Kerala, we are getting 6 crores.
Yes, the adjoining Kerala, they are getting 6 crores. It's high time that if we want to do something for them, if we want to do constructive, it is impossible to do within the MP lads, which is being this thing. So I would like the finance minister to suggest and through us, and I think this also, both the benches will agree, and to take that also forward. And this. No, in Tamil Nadu it is 12,000, where the central government gives. No, sir.
You go ahead with your speech.
So while allocating funds, it's important that the efficiency criteria, like more tax revenues, the financial management, infrastructure needs for faster growth, should be considered for distributing of funds to the states especially. And like states like Tamil Nadu should be rewarded, because we have been affected not only by the vertical devolution, that is the share between the state and the union territories, but also in the horizontal distribution, the revenue of the states. We are being, because what we give and what we get, there is a big difference between that. Like for example, the state share in central taxes amounts to more than 30,000 crores. The Tamil Nadu government's total GST revenue estimation is around rupees 64,023 crores. TN's contribution to the union tax is large, but the state gets just one-tenth in return. States are losing The legitimate chair from the vertical revolution has already said. So, where the Tamil Nadu has recorded a faster growth rate of Indian economy than the national rate. So, states which are contributing more are getting less. It is also the second largest in terms of gross state domestic product. I would also like to say, in this appropriation bill, it is heartening to see that the transfer to states has been increased by a large amount. And I would like to know if the state's share of 7,825 crores of the interstate GST would be released through this appropriation bill to the state of Tamil Nadu. And states like Maharashtra, Gujarat, Haryana and Tamil Nadu receive less than rupees 30 from the rupees 100 that is being given. Whereas states like some states get more than rupees 100 and more than rupees 200. And always in a country's GDP, a country's growth, a young nation's growth, a developed nation's growth, a developing nation's growth is always judged on what the government spends GDP on education and on healthcare. But it's very, very sad to see. I hope the finance minister takes a note of that and increases the GDP of education from what it is at present, from 1.2 to 1.4% to a higher percent, and regarding that is in healthcare. So the GDP on healthcare should be increased. Like developed countries spend around 18% of their GDP on health, whereas we are around 1.5. And I would also like to know if the AIIMS, which was announced in Madurai in the Union Budget of 2014-15, and then it was to be at Madurai in the year, it was declared the year, announced in the year 2018 December before the elections, and the foundation stone was laid by the Prime Minister on January 2019. It's just that the foundation stone still exists. Not one brick or stone has been added to that. I would like to know if the amount would be released soon for the AIIMS Madurai Medical College to take off. And also a railway line which was promised by the railway minister just before the elections. I don't want to see it just as an election stunt. It's good that we benefit from it. The Morpur Dharmapuri railway line, which they had sanctioned the amount which they had allocated of 358.95 crores. But just a few lakh of rupees has only been released. I please take this opportunity to kindly suggest to the finance minister to release the amount through the railways so that this work too gets done. And we have high regards and respect for you, madam. And we want to see this as an appropriation bill, and it shouldn't be judged as a misappropriation bill, especially to Tamil Nadu. Please do consider, and thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, sir.
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா ப்ளீஸ் லைக் அண்ட் ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க. மறக்காம எங்க சேனலை சப்ஸ்கிரைபும் பண்ணுங்க.